Welcome to lecture number 7, Armature Reaction in DC Motor. We'll cover 6 points. Number 1, definition of armature reaction. Number 2, main field flux and armature flux. Number 3, geometric neutral axis and magnetic neutral axis. Number 4, armature reaction. Number 5, effects of armature reaction. And number 6, methods to reduce armature reaction. First point, definition of armature reaction. In DC machine, that is motor or generator, two kinds of magnetic fluxes are present. Number one is armature flux and second is main field flux. So the effect of armature flux on the main field flux is known as armature reaction. Now, what is main field flux and armature flux? The construction of DC motor. In this we have field and armature. So the function of field is to produce magnetic flux. So we have north pole and south pole, which is energized from DC supply. So the function of field pole is to produce magnetic flux so that when a current carrying conductor is placed in magnetic field, it will experience a mechanical force and the conductors will rotate. But as we know that basic, when current flows through any conductor, there is flux around the conductor. So the main field flux is flux produced by the field system, and armature flux is the flux produced by the armature conductors of the DC motor. Now take a close look at main field flux and armature flux. So in the first diagram, we have field pole, that is north pole, and a part of armature where in the slots conductors are placed. So fluxes are starting from north pole and ending at south pole. The south pole is not shown in the diagram. So this is your south pole. So the flux produced by the main pole, that is called main field flux. Now in the second diagram, armature flux. So when armature conductors carry electric current, they create their own fluxes, and the resultant flux is shown by the circular dotted lines. So this is called armature flux, that is flux produced by armature conductors when they carry electric current. Third point, geometric neutral axis and magnetic neutral axis. The geometrical neutral axis is the axis that bisects the angle between the center line of adjacent poles. So clearly it is the axis of symmetry between two adjacent poles. So what is GNA? GNA is the line which bisects angle between the center line of adjacent poles. So this is the center line of adjacent pole, and the angle between two lines is bisected by the line that is called GNA. It is also called as Q axis, that is quadrature axis. The next point is MNA, magnetic neutral axis, which is also called as D axis or direct axis. So MNA is the axis drawn perpendicular to the mean direction of flux passing through the center of the armature. Now we know that the lines of fluxes are passing from north pole to south pole. So the line which is drawn perpendicular to the mean direction of the fluxes passing through the center of the armature. So these are the lines, red lines passing through the center of the armature, and the line which is perpendicular to these lines of fluxes is called as MNA. So generally MNA coincides with GNA to achieve sparkless commutation. armature reaction. So this takes place when main field flux and armature flux comes in contact with each other. So the main field flux are passing from north pole and going towards south pole, and in this case in armature flux these are circulating in clockwise direction. So these are going upward and these are going downward. So the flux passing from north pole, so these two fluxes on the left hand side cancels each other, and the two fluxes on right hand side supports each other. So therefore the diagram becomes like this. So the portion, in this portion the fluxes are cancelled, and in this portion the fluxes are stronger. So the portion where two magnetic fields are cancelled, the effect is called as demagnetizing effect or weakening effect due to armature reaction, where two fluxes are cancelled or demagnetized. And the second portion where two fluxes are added, that is main field flux is added with armature flux, and due to this the direction of main field flux is changed. It should be perpendicular but it is changed, therefore this effect is called as cross magnetizing or distorting effect. Now to understand the armature reaction in the machine, consider two pole machine. So here we have north pole and south pole. Between we have armature which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So there are total 18 armature slots. Under N pole there are 9 slots and under south pole there are 9 slots. So under N pole we have cross and under south pole we have dot. Means what? For cross the current is going into the conductor. So therefore the magnetic flux produced is clockwise direction, and for dot the current is coming out of the conductor. So the magnetic flux is in anti-clockwise direction. So the complete diagram becomes like this. So here it shows all conductors creating their own magnetic fluxes. So conductors under north pole they are creating in clockwise direction, and under south pole they are creating in anti-clockwise direction. So in this case we have both fluxes, that is flux due to main field flux and flux due to armature conductor, that is armature flux. So this causes main magnetic flux distort from its main position like this. So this is your north pole and this is your south pole. So due to this the MNA, that is the axis which is crossing mean direction of flux, gets shifted. So this is the new position of MNA, and this is due to armature reaction. So armature reaction has two effects. One is called demagnetizing effect and second is called cross magnetizing effect. So demagnetizing causes weakening of flux, that is the two fluxes cancels each other, and in cross magnetizing effect the main flux gets distorted or it changes its position. So therefore it is called as cross magnetizing effect or distorting effect due to armature reaction. Effects of armature reaction. So the first effect is due to armature reaction main flux gets weakened, that is called demagnetizing effect. So as we have seen here in this portion, this is demagnetizing effect or weakening of main flux, and this is the second effect is distorting effect, that is the path of main flux changes from its main position. So as it is required to travel flux like this, but due to armature reaction it changes its main path, and due to this the main flux is like this. So this is called distorting effect. The third is, due to armature reaction the position of magnetic neutral axis gets shifted, and this leads to sparking between the surface of commutator and brush. As we have seen, the MNA is shifted like this. So from its main position it gets shifted. So in motor the MNA will shift in opposite to the direction of rotation, and in generator it will shift in the direction of rotation. And number four, it increases iron loss. So due to armature reaction there is increase in iron loss of DC machine. Methods to reduce armature reaction. So armature reaction can be reduced by using compensating winding, second by using interpoles, number three chamfering, number four introducing saturation in the teeth and pole shoe. So this is the end of lecture number 7 on armature reaction. The armature reaction in DC motor or DC generator is same. The only difference, the shifting of MNA. So in DC motor the magnetic neutral axis due to armature reaction shifts in opposite direction to the rotation of motor, and in DC generator the MNA due to armature reaction shifts in the direction of rotation. So in this lecture we have covered 6 points. Number 1, what is armature reaction? Second, what is main field flux and armature flux? Number 3, geometric neutral axis and magnetic neutral axis. What is the procedure of armature reaction? Number 5, effects of armature reaction and how to